Teaching art in schools is not principally about making pretty pictures, but it's really about getting people thinking, getting people expressing themselves. All schools should be art schools because everything is made, everything has been constructed by somebody who's thought about it, and it started with an idea about a drawing. All that has been designed by somebody, and that conversation has started with a pencil and paper, and that conversation starts in school.
I'm Naomi Cleaver, and I'm a designer, writer and broadcaster.
I know that studying art subjects can be enjoyable and rewarding. I even think they make you better at other subjects because they help you concentrate and make you think more creatively. But can studying art and design, or design and technology, really lead to a career? Some people think that there are very few opportunities, but today there are in fact 2.8 million creative jobs in the UK. That's one in 12 jobs. And some people say, oh, you're too clever to study art or design. But most of the UK's brightest talents studied these subjects at school and then at university, and went on to a successful career in the creative industries.
I'm Miss Adams, I teach art, photography and ceramics here, and I want to talk about why you should take art and design. So the reasons I would say, it develops your independence, it's creative, it's all about you and your ideas. So from art and design, you can get a career in a variety of different places, the tattoo industry, fashion design, ceramics, artists, animation, movie designs, makeup artists, costume design, the list is endless really. There's so many different things you can take forward as an art and design student and use it in the future.
I'm Mr. Warner, I'm in charge of the ceramics for the school. Ceramics is all about learning by doing. So instead of working a lot in your sketchbooks, a lot of the time you're actually making things, learning new processes. This course is a really good one if you're someone that actually enjoys making things rather than working 2D, if you actually want to see things in a 3D form. It's a very good course to have if you're interested in going into anything to do with sort of architecture or into sort of prop and design sort of things like you're having film sets. A lot of people like sort of automotive designers have a background in this kind of subject as well.
Hi, I'm Mr. Wilde and I teach graphic communications at Kenton School. Graphic communications is all about the way in which artwork, design and images inhabit our everyday life. In graphics you'll get to try out a range of different processes and materials, but you'll often find that you'll be doing quite a lot of digital work such as photography and editing images in Photoshop. If you like bright, bold and eye-catching designs that serve more of a functional purpose in everyday life, then chances are graphic communications could be a good option for you.
Hi, my name is Mr. Bainbridge. I am the photography teacher here at Kenton, and I want to talk to you about picking GCSE photography. It's one of the most popular and increasingly more popular GCSE options for art, and I think it's a great option for you if you're really good at taking photographs, if you are always on Instagram. We'll be doing some things like photo shoots, we'll be going out on visits, we'll be doing Photoshop work, learning how to edit your shots to make them really exciting, and maybe we might get into the darkroom as well and do some traditional photography. It leads into lots of interesting careers such as wedding, events photography, sports photography, and also areas in the creative industries like film and TV as well as animation.
Hello, my name is Mrs. Jovlin and I teach textiles here at Kenton. I'm here to talk to you a little bit about what you could possibly do when you take this as an option in year 8. So if you're someone who likes to experiment a lot with fabrics and materials, who loves to print and dye, textiles could be a really good choice for you. So in textiles you get the best of both worlds because we do a lot of painting, a lot of drawing, and we study some fantastic artists, but you also get to go a lot of the time on the machines in the rooms. If you do take textiles, there's a huge range of careers available to you once you leave school, and we've got students, past students now in the fashion and textiles industry, but it also opens doors in industries such as interior design, theatre and costume, illustration and also the gift industry. The way it works in textiles, you get a lot of freedom. So how we run the courses, we would do lesson workshops with you and teach you new skills. And then with those new skills, you're allowed to then take that into your own themes and your own end products. There's a lot of choice of what you end up making, from anything from flat textile art to something which is 3D and sculpted to garments. There's also lots of trips to look forward to if you take textiles, and we try to get all the air groups out at least once a year. Places like colleges, universities, exhibitions. So if you do take textiles and you need to know any more, please feel free to pop along to D111.